What's good, Craig Gang? As you read the title, and if you look closely on the thumbnail, you will see that over the last 2 days, I have bought a kayak.
Now, like the title says, this is literally
the cheapest kayak I could find on the internet.
Like, straight up brand new fishing kayak, that's the cheapest one they sell.
It's a Sun Dolphin. It says it's a Journey 10 SS, which, I mean, I'm guessing it's 10 foot long. I don't know.
I honestly have no idea. I know nothing about kayaks. Like, I'm not kidding whenever I say that. I don't know anything about kayaks. I have fished out of one once, but that was about it. I didn't even catch a fish. And I know that a lot of fishing kayaks, especially some of the higher end ones, they can get over $1,000 and even up to like $2,000 and $3,000.
And I'll be honest, guys, I'm just a little high schooler from Kentucky. I don't have that kind of money to drop on a kayak.
So I just went to Amazon and got the cheapest one I could find.
Amazon's the place for everything, guys. I don't know if y'all know that.
And also, I don't know if you've realized this, but on my last like 2 or 3 videos, way down at the bottom of the description, it says my gear, and I put links to all the gear I've been using with the Amazon link. That way, if you're wondering, like, what camera do I use?
What minnow trap do I use?
What kayak do I use? I put all those links down there.
So if you're seeing some of the gear I'm using and you want to know exactly everything about it, you can go down and click the link,
and it'll take you up to the Amazon page and tell you all the stats on it.
The specs on it.
So with me being a straight up noob with kayaks, I'm gonna tell you everything I know about this. So it's 10 foot long, it's like a green camo, it's got a seat, and it came with a paddle. That's about all I know, guys. And it comes with 2 rod holders, which is, you know, made it look that much better online. I can't tell you what that thing is. I mean, I just now realized it had that.
It's got bungee straps on it. I think this,
well, yeah, this thing comes out. I don't know what it does, but it comes out. I may have just broke it. I don't know.
Yeah, I think I might have just broke this.
I'm just going to put it back in there and act like I didn't do anything.
Hopefully, we can get out there and use it today. I mean, we do got some clouds rolling in, some thunder way out there.
But yeah, guys, there's the new kayak. I'll give y'all a little, you know, first person what it looks like. So here's what it looks like whenever you get in it. You know, just like a kayak, I guess. I mean, I don't know if there's anything special about it, but this is what it looks like. I don't know how stable it'll be, but I mean, I guess it can't be too bad.
It had good reviews,
and that's basically what I went off of.
If it had good reviews and it was a pretty decent price, hey, I just said, yeah, man, let's get it.
I mean, from what I can tell right now, it seems super sturdy, but then you gotta take into consideration I'm on gravels and not water.
That could make a big difference after you think about it.
But if we do get to go fishing today, let me show you what we're gonna be fishing with.
It's actually an MTB box, but I've done took a peek into this month's box, and it is amazing.
It is straight up my favorite to date. I'm not even kidding.
May's MTB box is literally stacked, guys.
I'm gonna find it hard to believe if I don't complete the MTB slam.
So here's what we got. We're gonna open up the box right here. First thing you get your little thing that shows you how to use each baits in there. The first thing you pull out, we got stinking wacky worms, guys. It looks like, I don't know, maybe cotton candy color.
Wacky worm, guys, that's like one of my number one fish catching baits. That's one of my favorite baits to catch fish. Starting it off good.
Second up, we have these cream little swim baits in here. They're in like a black light color where it's black and dark purple.
But then because I've already looked in here, I'll know that there is also a black chatterbait in here in the same midnight color.
Now what that's for, these two can go perfectly together, and I'll show you how to do that out there on the water.
But you can thread these swim baits up on this chatterbait, and with the black and purple, it's perfect for night fishing.
I'll be completely honest, guys, I don't night fish much at all. I mean, a lot of people around my area do night fish, but personally with me, I like to sleep whenever it gets dark outside, so I just fish during the day.
But no doubt, guys, we will probably still catch a fish on that, even though it is in the daytime.
Those baits aren't exclusively for fishing at night, but they do really well at night too. They excel at night.
Next up in the box, if wacky worm was my second favorite lure, y'all already know what my first favorite is. It would be a jerkbait. And that's exactly what they gave.
They gave us this little jerkbait here. It's a suspending jerkbait. It's a little large. It's in, I think, a 110 size.
We got a good shiny belly right there, and that's all you need in a good jerkbait.
We should definitely get a fish on that also.
Then over here, which may be the death of my MTB slam, we got this giant, like, pencil popper.
It is Japanese designed right there, but to be honest, guys, I don't do much with pencil poppers.
I mean, I'm guessing the action is going to be exactly like a little spook, which, I mean, I'd say it will be. We can probably still get a bass on that.
But the cool thing is whenever they give you a topwater walking bait and you're saying that's the worst bait in the box, that's pretty good because this is still a really awesome bait.
We have a jig. Now, this is just a stand-up jig. It's even got little wires back here
to make it stand up even more perfectly.
I'll probably take a crawl or something that's not in the box and put on the back of this. But either way, all those baits right there, I don't think I'll have any problem at all catching fish on those.
And then the last thing in the box, I've never really saw this before, but it's defishing soap.
It's soap to, you know, make your fans smell like, well,
not fish.
I really don't know how we're gonna rig this, but I'm sure we can catch fish on it somehow. We got a brand new kayak, an amazing looking outfit box over there. If you want a mystery tackle box yourself, you can go to Mystery Tackle Box, their website, and use my promo code GREYGANG right here. It'll give you like $10 off your first box. And when the standard box is only $15, you're getting a standard box for $5 for your first month. And with those baits in it right there, like, bro, you're gonna be making money like that. The exact link for that is gonna be down in the description also. You can go click the link and it'll take you straight to it. Okay, guys, we got a plot twist. So as I done told you this, we were supposed to go fishing in the kayak today. So, you know, I went up to my mom, I'm like, okay, mom, I'm going out with the kayak. I'm gonna go fishing at my friend's pond. Her response,
no.
And so just like that, we went from going bass fishing, trying to complete an MTB slam in a kayak, to now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go practice in the kayak. And what does kayak practice consist of? Well, to be honest, guys, I don't even know. But I'm pretty sure it's just go out to a pond and float around. I literally think that's all we're doing today. But do not fear, guys. Next video, I'm pretty sure we'll actually get to go fishing out of this thing. Now, I got to set up everything out here on the trapping shack on wheels. Got it back here on the back. One problem. If I try to go through a narrow spot, I don't think it's going to work. Because the mule is now 10 feet wide instead of like 5 feet wide. But that's okay. For some places. Other places, other ponds, well, we may never get to fish them. That's okay though. At least we have a kayak, Greg. At least we have a kayak. But anyways, without further ado, we're going to get on down to the pond. What I'm going to do today, my main focus, is one, of course, practice not dying in a kayak. Two, practice not flipping in a kayak. Three, learning how to paddle in a kayak. And four, I want to play around with some camera angles. Now right here, I do have a chest cam on. But with me sitting down in a kayak, I don't know how well that'll work out. So that's what we're going to test today. We're also going to test this angle right up here. See, with the little GoPro mount like that. That way you'll hopefully get an angle something like this to where you're looking back at me, you know, do the big swarping hook set looking outfit thing. But like I just said, that's what we're going out there to do. We're going out there to test camera angles and we're going out there to practice not dying in a kayak. That is basically the goal for today. And we have approximately 6 hours to do it. And we're also going to a pond that gets like no deeper than 5 feet. Let's go. Ahoy, passengers. I'm Kendall Gray, and today, I'm gonna be captain of the USS Gray Gang. See you at the port. Woo! Okay, guys, we're here. Now all I gotta do is get in the boat. One, put my life jacket on. My bad. I'm way too close to the water's edge to not have a life jacket on. But don't worry, guys. I can change that real quick. Now, the next question is, how are we going to infiltrate this large line of reeds right here? We do have a thin spot right here, along with a thin spot right here. I'm not exactly sure how we're going to advance into the water column, but no worries. We're going to figure it out.
Okay, so, I mean, I guess step one, get the kayak turned that way, get the paddle. I guess we'll just try to infiltrate it right here. Shouldn't be too bad right here, you know? First time ever launching a kayak, and hopefully it's not my last. And we're in. We are officially almost in the pond. We're not there yet. Okay, now we're in the pond. We are officially in the pond with my Crocs on. Let's see how fast I can ram the bank. I guess that's what you do in a kayak. I don't know. Okay, cool. I'm gonna break down my little Darth Maul looking outfit. Paddles right here. I have two. See what I can do this way. I don't know how effective it'll be, but I sure do feel cool. That's really all that matters. As long as I feel like a Jedi, I am a Jedi. Now we're getting over here to the grassy side of the pond. Starting to shake a little bit. We're gonna put it back together because that's the way it's built, I guess. But I mean, yeah, overall first impressions, exactly like I thought it'd be. I'm just floating around in a boat, pretty much what I expected, not gonna lie. You get wet pretty easy. I don't like that.
We've hit dry ground. Oh man, the one thing I've noticed, I've not had the kayak long. You've watched me. I've been in the water like a total of 2 minutes. Here's what I've learned so far. If you get in a kayak, prepare to be drowned. You are not gonna stay dry in a kayak. I don't think it's possible, I'll be honest. I don't think it's possible at all.
See?
What is that? What is that?
Can I stand up in this kayak? The answer, no, I cannot.
Okay, guys, now that I've spent about 12 minutes in a kayak, I'm basically professional and I'm ready to tell you what I think about it. Number one thing that I've realized about a kayak is that it is not meant to be a dry boat. Like, look in here, there's water everywhere. If you plan on going out with like sweatpants or jeans or something, be prepared for those sweatpants or jeans or something to be wet. Because listen, guys, every time you swing the paddle, the other side literally just comes in and dumps on you. So you're gonna get wet and you're gonna get real wet. But I mean, besides taking in a gallon of water every time you paddle, I think it's a pretty good machine overall. I mean, you can definitely go places that you can't in a jumbo, and it's a whole lot easier to paddle, and I'm guessing you can be a whole lot more stealthy. I don't really know about bed fishing in this thing. I don't really know about standing up in this thing. I tried it and I almost died, so I sit back down. But I mean, besides that, guys, that's basically all I figured out today. Is I one, got comfortable with the kayak. I tested a few camera angles. Right now I'm using the chest cam. I did have, I don't know, the point cam, I guess. Figured out how not to drown. And besides that, guys, I think we completed our objective. And one last thing, guys, before I sign off, go down in the comments and I want you to tell me, what should we name the boat? Should I name it the USS Grey Gang, or should I name it something else? And if you've watched the video this far and you're not subscribed, go ahead, hit the subscribe button. That way you'll be ready for every time we go out fishing this year. And while you're at it, turn on your notifications. Now, as always, if you like the kayak video and if you're ready for Thursday video where we actually go fishing with it, go ahead and hit the like button. And without further ado, guys, hey boys, I'll see you later.
What's good, Grey Gang? Thank you all for watching. Go support Kendall Grey and buy his merch, link in the description down below. Hope y'all loved his video. Like always, they're the best. I'm gonna get back to my food plot. Yeah, thank y'all for watching.